satin, white satin, never reaching the end. Letters I've written, never meaning to send.
We can see behind you those plumes of smoke still rising from the World Trade Center, what's left of it. Describe the mood and the atmosphere and what you can see there.
Well, as you can see, that is indeed where the World Trade Center was. I think many Americans here, New Yorkers, just cannot believe that when that plume of smoke goes, that landmark will not be there. And the, of course, the 50,000 people who worked in that building every day, we don't know their fate yet. Up and down behind me, you can see ambulances coming frequently, taking victims, injured. We don't know. There's almost a total news blackout. This part of the city is completely closed. But we do know the hospitals are taking in people with very severe burns and injuries from the debris that fell from around the World Trade Center with the initial planes colliding with the buildings. Of course, the area around the World Trade Center was evacuated when the towers themselves collapsed. But there's very much here a sense of not real panic, but of people wanting to get out of the city if they can. I saw huge streams of people walking uptown as far away as possible, and people coming out of buildings, people just almost totally evacuating the high-rise buildings. The Empire State, for example, nearby was also totally evacuated. So crowds of people on the pavement and wondering what on earth has happened, how can this have happened as well.
Now, Jane, Rudy Giuliani, the mayor, has taken a very tough stand. He's evacuated the whole of the area. What else is coming out of City Hall?
Very little, apart from he is talking of tremendous numbers of casualties, talking in the thousands, because, of course, we have no confirmed death or injured figures. There's actually too much chaos here. For example, the main cellular telephone connections were on top of the World Trade Center, so people can't get through to each other. That's very sad and just horrific for people who are looking for loved ones. I mean, I've seen people crying in the street, desperately bashing their cell phones, trying to get through to family members and trying to see where they are. So it's in this chaos, because of a scale of a tragedy of an attack like this, there is very, very little firm information.
Jane, are you getting a sense, really, that almost a way of life has begun to seize up in parts of New York City and beyond into the state? Because, of course, many of those working down in Wall Street would have commuted in.
Totally, and this is something that is going to continue and get worse during the day. I mean, for example, Wall Street and the whole financial area and the whole downtown area is closed. Trading has been suspended on the New York Stock Exchange. And I know, because I live further uptown in New York, I'm going to be having to put people up in my apartment tonight, because they won't be able to get down there to, it's most likely, to actually go home. People who need to get across the bridges and tunnels, people who would have perhaps been flying home after working here during the day or over the weekend, they can't get anywhere. The airports are closed. It is a city that is sealed, in a way, in this dreadful event.
And what can one imagine about the way of life? In other words, the basics of life, like sanitation, water and so on, because you are talking about an enormous area down there and people who have to service it all.
No, it is a huge area, and you can't imagine how long this is going to take to put together. I mean, 50,000 people alone work in the World Trade Center, or did until today. How many people work in that huge, busy area? Those pavements would have been crowded with people when this accident, this attack happened. So trying to restore the services from this kind of damage is going to be huge. It's going to take a long time for New York to recover physically with its cell phones, its sanitation, like you said, but I think emotionally for New York to recover and for Americans to recover. They're worried about an attack like this, but it never seemed real that something like this could develop and they could watch it happening on their television screens, as is what happened today.
Well, Jane Stanley, thanks for joining us live from South Manhattan. You can see in the background behind Jane there what's left of the World Trade Center, the smoke, the dust, the rubble burning, and the dust plume still rising after what happened earlier today, about almost 5 hours ago. It began.